up, bro? What's up? What's up? What's up with you, King? Tapping in, man. Tapping in, tapping in. Tapping in with the family. Tapping in with everybody. You know, Zen mode. Good energy. God energy. You know, always got to get on here and get on social media and just put out that good vibration. We tend to need it from time to time. You know, that's my mission. You know, always high vibrations all the time. Always high vibrations. Always important to tap in with the people, you know. The social media world. Zen vibes, tapping in with the family. Hope everyone is doing well. You know. Cuzzo's in the building. Tap in with me, man. Tap in with me. Come on. Tap in with me. I put take a deep breath as the title for a specific reason. People don't pay attention to their breathing, especially throughout the day. You know, it's important to pay attention to your breathing, you know, and taking a deep breath throughout the day, you know, and slow everything down. The other day I was meditating, and when I realized once you clear your thoughts and you become in the moment, that is the most peaceful feeling that anyone can ever feel. You know, just being in the moment, not thinking about anything else. And one of the things I challenge people, if you're in here right now, I challenge you to drop your phone, drop everything, and just go outside for a walk. No electronics, nothing. Just go outside for a walk. You will be amazed how your mind starts to create new ideas and new type of vibration and new energy for yourself. So take some time out and just go out into nature with no phone and just walk. And just walk. Detach yourself from your phone, from time, and just go for a walk. Specifically in nature. I know it's kind of hard to do it inside of like big cities because, you know, we got buildings and it's a lot going on. You got a lot of people around, so you're constantly consuming different type of energy. But if you can, you know, walk to your local park by yourself in nature and just detach yourself from any like type of like cell phone device. Leave your cell phone at home. Most people are super like connected to their phones and they do not know how to disconnect. So make sure you try to do that. If you could do it once a day, it's beautiful. If you could do it once or twice a week, I strongly suggest that for your own mental health. Mental health is something that we don't talk about enough. And, you know, having different tools and techniques to help that, help you along this journey. This is what I'm trying to provide here on my platform. You know. So, yeah. Just had to share that. Make sure you go into nature. That's important for your spirit, for your energy, for just life in general. We're so attached to our phones, and the scary thing is like you get it, and even I go through it, right? Like you'll be on your phone so long, and then you look at the time, you like, wow, like 2 hours went by, an hour went by, and I was on my phone just, you know, getting different dopamine hits. You know, scrolling on the feed. So it's important to make sure you get into nature, get into your Zen mode, leave your phone at home and get into nature. If you can do that at least once a week or once a day, if you can, please do that. You know, it's a beautiful feeling when you detach yourself from, you know, your cell phone or just anything else. Family's in the building. You know, so I just want to get on here and just, you know, slow everything down for people. Everybody's at this, you know, fast pace and everybody's moving so much, but no one's taking the time out just to breathe. You know, so I try to get on these lives so when people, you know, see my live pop up and it says take a deep breath, you know, in their mind, it already triggers you to say, you know, all right, let me breathe real quick. I haven't paid attention to my breathing. So thank you for tuning in. I hope everyone is doing well. I hope you're having a marvelous, extraordinary day today. Just being alive is a beautiful thing that people tend not to appreciate until we lose a loved one or something like that. So just appreciate the fact that you're here in this present moment is the first key towards, you know, your journey of life and having joy. And it's super hot outside, so make sure you get a little bit of sun, but, you know, protect yourself at the same time. It's one hot summer. I feel like we're closer to the sun. That's another conversation for another day. Hope everyone is doing marvelous today. You know, if we're in here, put your gems in here. It's important. You know, how's everyone's mental health doing? You know, what are you doing right now to take care of your mental health? What are you doing right now? Right now in this moment to take care of yourself. That's very, very important. Very important. Without looking for anyone outside of you to help, what are you doing for you right now? Right now. We forget how, it's crazy because people forget how extraordinary they are. You know? We forget how extraordinary we are and the abilities that we have with inside ourselves, you know. And you hear it all the time, right? You hear the man that once was a homeless man, you know, become a multimillionaire. You know, I seen a TED Talks with a guy with no limbs, literally no limbs, no arms, no legs, and he is on stage speaking, and he speaks around the world. Those two situations just show you how the human spirit and how powerful the human spirit is. So once you look at those, you know, situations and those people, get inspired and realize, you know, each and every one of us have the same abilities. You know, we can do extraordinary things. Us as human, we can do extraordinary things. If you're in a rough patch right now, just understand that's just the current circumstance. That does not define who you are and what you're capable of in this world. It just shows you, oh wow, like I can go that far, you know. So me just seeing a man on stage with no limbs speaking to the world, you know, or a man come from, or a woman come from nothing and achieve, you know, everything they desire in this world is a beautiful, beautiful thing. And it's just so, you know, more reassurance that it's all possible. You know, speaking, one of my ultimate goals is to do a TED Talks. I want to speak on stage, and I've had this goal for a while now, and every single day I'm just trying to manifest it. I'm just putting it into the universe that one day I'm gonna get on stage and I'm gonna be able to speak to the world and inspire and motivate people to find tranquility inside themselves and also to do amazing things in this world. I think everyone has light inside of them, but we just need to discover that. And I want to be that person that helps people discover that light inside of them. So, you know, the journey doesn't end, and every single day, you know, it's important to, you know, better yourself and strive every single day. Get it going. And I told one of my partners this: 1% every day. If you get better at something 1% every day, by the end of the year, that's 365%. Wow, just 1%. And it's a beautiful feeling, you know, when you look back at it, you're like, wow, like I started there, but now I'm here. So each and every day, try to get better. Enjoy this life, man. Enjoy each and every moment. Do not let people you know, define who you are. Don't let people tear you down when you're trying something different. Not everyone's gonna understand you. It is not meant for that, you know. So continue to strive. Continue every single day, you know. Get around the right people. One of my mentors, he literally did 20 years in jail. He had life in jail. 16 years old, life in jail. And you know what he told me? While he was in jail, he had life. He created something called a positive delusion. So the positive delusion is basically each and everything that you desire in this world, no matter what it is. They call it a delusion for a reason, right? They say delusional, that means it's not real. Everything that he wanted to achieve in this world, the cars he wanted, the type of house he wanted, the type of places he wanted to travel to, and he put it in his jail cell. So he put it in his jail cell, he would look at it every single day. This man had life in prison. Mind you, he's my mentor right now. So at some point, he got out of that situation. So I'm saying that to say this. Sometimes you might have a goal, admiration, something that you're striving towards, and you might have people around you that will diminish that because they don't have no type of vision for themselves. So when they hear your vision and they hear that you want to do something, they're quick to break it down. But you can't be mad at these individuals. You have to simply understand they do not see what you see. So make sure you're around people that think big, that think extraordinary. So when you share ideas with them, they're like, wow, like, how can I add on to that? They're not like, wow, I can't even see that. Nah, that's not going to happen. The minute someone tells you, I don't think that's going to work for you, I don't think you should do that, please immediately separate yourself as fast as possible. One of the good things that I pride myself on is that even if a person around me tells me I can't do something, I can tune people out real quick. Like, I'm like super, super, super good at it. It's a good and a bad thing because sometimes a person will be speaking to me and literally in my mind, they're on mute. Like, just straight up mute. I cannot hear them. So it's very important to tune people out that are not sharing the same vision with you. And in a lot of the cases, it's the people that you love the most that are going to tell you you can't do something. I had, you know, friends and family members that are like, nah, you're not going to do this. You're not going to do that. And, you know, at one point I listened to it and I consumed it into my mind and I took it and I held on to it. And in my subconscious mind, every time I tried something, I'm like, ah, nah, I can't do that. But I realized over time, you have to quiet like the noise, quiet the noise. And one of the things that us as people, we love support from each other, right? We love when, you know, people are telling us like, yo, go try to go do that. We hate when someone tells you you can't do something. So it's important to turn down the volume on people that don't believe in your goals. And do not even be upset at them. Like, literally do not be upset at anyone. If someone tells you you can't do something, please do not be upset, because what you're doing is you're transferring that same energy into anger now. And that right there is not going to help at all. Like, that energy is not going to help at all. So make sure, this is why I preach so much, you know, meditation and going zen and really going within, because over the past 2 years, I've went into the deepest places inside myself. I've healed from a lot of childhood traumas in my life. Hope I said that right, childhood traumas in my life. I've forgiven a lot of people I've personally felt have done me wrong. And I went into places, I've even forgiven myself for things that, for situations I've done wrong to people and bad decisions I've made for myself, you know. So it's really important, as important as possible, for you as an individual to really go zen, go inside yourself, and protect your energy. Protect your energy. That right there is the biggest key. Please, family, if you're watching this right now, please, 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 as I sit here in this moment and I tell you this, I mean this from the bottom of my heart, protect your energy. Each and every person around you is energy. Every thought is energy. When you move, when you walk, is energy. The food that you consume inside your body is energy. So please, as much as possible, try your best to protect that and be very aware of the energies that's around you. I know some of us are very loving and caring individuals, and we want the best for each and every person, right? So you'll be in a conversation with someone that you know in the bottom of your heart, that person doesn't have the best intentions for you. So please, please, please stand guard at the door of your spirit. Like, it's the body. The body's the physical part. This is what we see, right? This is what we see. Then it's the spirit. But you have to have a higher consciousness where you're standing guard at that and you're not allowing, you know, any negative energy inside your, you know, inside your realm, inside your aura, inside your vibration. So please be aware of that, because all of us, each and every one of us, have a specific idea, goal, vision that we want to share with the world. We want to create, we want to make the world a better place, make ourselves better. And sometimes you get around the wrong people, get into the wrong situations, and these individuals will break down your visions and your goals. So please, if you're watching this right now, please, if I could, you know, really dig into someone's soul right now, protect your energy at all costs, you know. So this is one of the reasons why I got on here. Please make sure throughout the day, take a deep breath. I know our minds are like highways, right? Our minds are like highways. We're constantly getting new thoughts, new downloads, especially with the things that we see around us. You're scrolling on social media. Odds are, if you're in this room right now with me, you was on social media. You've seen a bunch of different things. In the past hour, you've seen a bunch of different information. Your mind is still trying to process things as you're sitting here, you know, with me right now. So make sure, please, 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 I stress this a lot. Take some time out to take a deep breath. Take a deep breath. You know, morning, noon, and night, do your breath work. Literally sit there in a chair. Hopefully it's like a chair that's comfortable. We need comfort is important, right? So you sit there in a chair. You inhale for, you could do 15 seconds, and then exhale for another 15 seconds. And you do it 3 times. Within doing that, it makes you more conscious of the now, of being here, being present. That is very, very, very important. Be here, be now, you know, be in the moment. Because as you're on the phone, taking in the feed, right? They call it the feed for a reason. As you're taking in the feed, it's feeding your mind. It's feeding your mind. Whether it's good or bad information, it's still feeding your mind. And your mind is not taking no time out to process what you're consuming. You haven't even got a chance to really seriously process anything. How long does it take to break down food? Let's think about this. How long does it take to break down a meal? It takes probably 4 to 5 hours to break down a meal. And that's the same thing with information on social media. How long does it take to break down the information that you was just scrolling on? And you haven't took no time out to actually process that. You haven't. You've been scrolling the whole time. So not one piece of information you fully have processed. You might see something and share it on your stories because, you know, that first 15 seconds it hit you. And now it's on your stories and other people are seeing it. But did you fully, fully, fully process that information? So please, family, take time out to breathe. morning, noon, and night, paying attention to your breath. It brings you back into the beauty of life. The most beautiful part of this life, of this existence, that we are here in the physical, is the now. Is the now, and being fully in the moment. That is the most beautiful part of life, is being present. So please, please, family, morning, noon, and night, do your breath work, breathe, you know, be in the moment, pay attention to the things that you're consuming, you know, protect your energy. That's the most important thing. Protect your energy as much as possible, please. And if you got a vision for sun, you got a goal for sun, if there's something that you want to achieve, work every damn day to achieve that. Work every day. And all you need is 1% each and every day. It is not about the product. It's not about the end goal. It's not. The end goal is not even that important. It's the process of getting there that's going to change who you are. It's the process of getting there that's going to change who you are as an individual. It will change you. I hear so many stories of people, of success stories, that people worked on certain things throughout their life, and they would tell me that it wasn't even the end goal of where I'm at. I'm happy and I appreciate it, but the process changed me. It made me a better individual. It made me a better person. So please, family, if you watch this, if you're watching this right now, please, one, protect your energy. Two, breath work, morning, noon, night. Pay attention to your breathing. Breathe every single day. You're breathing regardless, right? You're talking. But paying attention to your breathing will bring you back into the moment. And that's the key to life, is being here and now, being in the moment. You know, so many great ideas are going to start coming to you. Like, oh, I want to try this. I could try that. Oh, this is cool. Because you're present. Too many of us are so focused on the past, or focused on what someone said to us, or focused on a situation we was in, a breakup that happened. You know, we focus on things that we're not getting that time back. That time is gone, done, finished. I know people that still talk about how they was cool in high school. Oh, they used to do this back then. It's not important no more. The most important thing is the now. The most important thing you have is now, right now, in this moment, as I speak these words, is the now. That's the most important thing that you have. So please, family, again, I'm gonna repeat this again. Protect your energy. Pay attention to your breathing. And 1% every day. Try to do something 1% better every single day. That's 365% in a year. You can master anything you want to achieve. You can master it. Okay, so just had to get on here and share some light, share some love, take a moment to take you out of whatever algorithm that you're in on your phone, whatever algorithm that you're in, whatever feed that's popping up. I wanted to take a moment and take you out of that and get present into the moment and tell you the importance of breathing and paying attention to your breath work. And you know, continue to enjoy each and every moment. Immerse yourself in the moment. When you're talking to someone, be present, be there, listen. Listening is a superpower that many of us understand. Some of us don't understand the art of listening. I read this book, The Art of Communication, and it really changed the way I approach each and every conversation that I'm in. You know, I really immerse myself and listen, like wholeheartedly listen to whoever's speaking, and I understand. It gets to a point where I kind of like feel what they're feeling because I'm so deep into like, oh wow, you know. So pay attention to the information that you're consuming every day. Again, family, again, most important thing, if you hear this, 1% every day, 1% every day. Work on something 1% every day. That's 365%. Protect your energy and pay attention to your breathing. Morning, noon, and night. Breath work. 15 seconds in, 15 seconds out. 15 seconds in, 15 seconds out. Three times a day. Morning, noon, and night. It's very important. Most of us are not even... The reason why we get upset and we get hot is because we're not breathing. We're not breathing. We're not paying attention to our breath. We're breathing at a rate and we don't even understand. And then we get... The next time you get upset, if somebody cross your path that you don't agree with, they say something, just breathe. That's why people, when you see someone upset and they walk away and they say, yo, just breathe, there's a specific reason they're telling you just breathe. It makes you more present. It makes you more alive. It makes you more in the moment. Because when you're upset, you're not alive. You're somebody else. You're somewhere else. And this is one of the reasons why I go back to, you know, meditation, mindfulness. And it's something I discovered within myself that I just want to share with others, because I understand life is crazy. And we're going to have those ins and outs, right? So many people that cross our paths are like, yo, you said what? Huh? You feel the type of way about something in the past? A lot is going on. But if you just take a moment out and just breathe. Just breathe, family. Like, just be, immerse yourself in the moment, which is one of the biggest keys, is really being in the moment. So I had to get on here just to, you know, lock in and just share, you know, some of my tools and techniques that has helped guide me throughout my life journey. And, you know, no one's life is perfect. You know, we all are going through something, or about to go through something, or been through something. So that makes us all connected. A couple people tuned in. And again, I appreciate each and every person that tuned into this one. Take a deep breath. Just be in the moment and understand that the light is already inside you. Let it shine now. Let that light shine. Let that light shine. No one can take it away. No one. All right, family. I appreciate you guys. I love you guys. Thank you for tuning in to another Zen moment. This one titled, Take a Deep Breath. Have a good one, family.